Hi, I'm Ting Nguyen with the Science Communication Lab. I'm so excited to talk this year to all of the Share Your Research participants and winners. Today, we're talking to Swati. Swati, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hey everyone, I'm Swati Shrestha, currently a PhD student in Vegetable Breeding and Genetics Lab at the University of Florida. My research work at the University of Florida focuses on development and application of molecular tools for accelerated breeding of disease resistance in squash that would ultimately increase squash growers' productivity and profitability.
And what motivated you to get into this field of science?
Actually, I'm originally from Nepal, where the agriculture is one of the major occupations of a lot of people. So growing up, farmers and farming community had a deep impact on me. I could see growers worrying about their crop and yield due to different factors like diseases, insects, pests, and whatnot. So I was always interested in getting into agricultural research, and here I am doing what I love.
Helping the farmers with their yield and productivity.
Yeah, exactly. So basically, the research that I am doing, we hope that we'll be able to develop squash varieties that are resistant to diseases so that the growers will have one less thing to worry about.
Yeah, and you're doing it faster too, right? How are you doing it faster than traditional breeding?
In case of traditional breeding, the plants need to be grown until maturity to select for the resistant individuals. But now in this era of science, we have molecular breeding so that we don't even need to grow the plants in the field to actually see if they are resistant or not. We just need to extract the DNA from the plants and then just use some molecular markers to see if the plants are resistant or not. And in this way, we can select the resistant plants without even growing them in the field. So that increases the varietal development process. And then we can get new varieties just within 4 to 5 years, where in traditional breeding, it can take up to 10 years for the development of new varieties.
You seem so excited as you talk about this. Were you always this excited about science? What was your first science memory?
Science has always been there with me ever since childhood. I would say specifically I was interested in gardening and plant science since early childhood. I remember I was in grade 2 when I had got some corn seed, and without thinking anything, I had just planted them in the pot. And then after a week or so, I just saw small plants coming out of the pots, and I realized I was so excited. I went to my mom and asked her how that happened. So she explained me that a small seed can give rise to an entire plant. I was so proud of the plant. I showed that plant to all my friends, and I even harvested real corn from that plant. So observing that small seed grow into an entire plant and then giving corn was my scientific memory of observing the plants grow. And then that's how I got interested in plant science. And here I am today doing a PhD in plant breeding and genetics.
Well, what is one thing about being a scientist that you wish other people knew?
Well, I think that when people hear the word scientist, they actually think of people spending a lot of time in their labs or in their workplace or people spending time in front of their books. But I think people should know that being a scientist is also about following one's passion and translating science into solution and trying to make this world a better place to live.
And for a young person going into your field, what are some of the greatest things about working as a plant scientist? And what are some of the most challenging?
For any young person who is trying to enter into my field, I would say that the greatest thing is we are working into something that is one of the most important things required for human civilization, that is food. So it gives me immense pleasure and satisfaction working on that field. And the biggest challenge I would say would be that we don't know when a new disease or pest would outbreak in a crop. So we always need to be ready to dive into the unknown and find solution to the immediate problems.
That's great advice. And I'm so excited for people to hear about your research talk that brings together, talks about bringing food to the table, your genetic analysis, your excellent experimentation, and the way that you tell the story. Thank you so much for joining us, Swati.
Thank you for having me. It was a pleasure, and we learned a lot from iBiology.